Trying to attract as many consumers as possible while being cost-effective is the daily struggle of small business owners and marketers alike. As consumers, we're constantly bombarded with advertisements, both online and offline, so quite frankly, we just don't accept bad marketing. Thus, the quest to engage consumers is never-ending. And a new form of media has cropped up because of this. It's called a cinemagraph. A cinemagraph is a picture with bits of movements to create a looping video. And today, you're going to learn how to make one. Let's do it. Cinemagraphs can be made with a variety of programs. Flixel, After Effects, and what we're going to be using, Photoshop. But before you do that, you're going to need to capture some footage. I'll be using my Canon 80D with my handy Tamron zoom lens, but you could use a iPad or a iPhone if you had to. Of course, the image quality is going to vary. Now, if you can shoot in 4K, by all means do it. I'm stuck with 1080p, and to keep it simple, I'm not going to do any time-lapse photography or shoot in RAW, I'm just going to shoot video. Before you actually go out and shoot, you're going to want to make sure that your camera is stable. The obvious solution is a sturdy tripod, but you could also use a sturdy desk, a GorillaPod, and even a sweater that cradles the camera. Just make sure that it is as sturdy as possible. Okay, once you've got your footage, let's go ahead and go into the program and make our cinemagraph. Alright, so the first thing we're going to want to do is find our footage. I just took my SD card from my camera, plopped it into the PC, and now I'm in Adobe Bridge so I can find it. Now, if you have an Apple machine, you can just use Previewer, but I don't. So let's say this was the clip I wanted to do or wanted to use for my cinemagraph. There it is. Found it. That's not what I'm going to be using. I'm going to use a different clip, and I'll show you this actually at the end. I showed you it at the beginning, but you know, I'll show you a real world example of this. The clip that I'm going to be using is actually here in a hard drive. Now, you would want to transfer your footage to a hard drive from your SD card, because working from the SD card is like really bad for it. You can wreak havoc on it. All right, so I found what I'm going to use here, this Chloe cinemagraph. Let's go ahead and fire up Photoshop. We're gonna start a new program, and you know, it looks a little bit different here because this is Adobe CC 2017. We're going to need to set our dimensions, and this is for Facebook. And I know the dimensions because I looked them up, and you, of course, should too to make sure it's optimal for whatever platform you're going to put this on. 1280 by 720. Just hit create, and here we are. And we are in the motion panel. Now, if you're wondering, like, how the heck do I get here? It's changed a bit from the old Adobe CC, but it's just this caret here, select motion. And that's gonna give us what we need here, a video timeline. So I'm going to take this footage here and just plop it right down. Of course, you could place it in there from file, but this is just the way I'm going to do it. And then we're going to find that footage. This is like a minute long. I don't need that much. You want to make it a short loop. You know, it's a cinemagraph. It's supposed to be short. So I'm right about here. 5 seconds is good enough. With our hard working barista here. I have the sound turned off, but it would be turned on and you would hear this. We don't want to hear that. You know, we don't want to hear that in the end production either. So you're going to hit this caret here, choose the musical note, and then mute audio. Much better. And if you have like multiple like video files and you can't figure out a way to get into them, just double click it. Should bring up a new spot, like a new tab, and then do the same thing. Okay, so here we go. Another thing you're going to want to do before you do anything else is go to the scroll wheel and select loop playback. And you know, just take a quick preview, see where things are, where you're going to mask things out. Of course, the cinemagraph works really well if you're going to use like motion. Oops, mine was turned off. Noob. Okay. And when you have motion, that's when cinemagraphs can really grab attention, because something will be still and something won't, and you'll be like, huh. Now, we have our basic loop. Of course, we wouldn't want to just use this because it's super choppy. The next thing we're going to want to do is find like our still frame, the thing that we're going to want to use for a picture. Of course, you know, you could stylize this, you know, bring up the lights, darks, do all that stuff that you do in Photoshop when you're doing photo editing. The normal way that I would do this is hold down Control Alt Shift E. I believe it's like Command Option Shift E if you're on a Mac. There's more than one way to do this though. That will give me, you know, that screenshot, that freeze frame, excuse me, that I would want to use. You could also copy the layer, Control J, right click, rasterize layer, then cut it down, pull it back up, or pull it up, either up here on the timeline or up here. Just another example, in case you can't find out how to do it. You have two ways now. Okay, so play it back. Of course, we can't see anything because we have the image on top. So let's go ahead and start masking it out. Select this little icon, and there's our mask. And so the way we're going to mask it out is just with a brush. If you have black paint right here, that will take the mask out. And you can alternate between black and white by hitting the X key, if you didn't know. If you want to get better, you can enter quick mask mode, hit backslash. You can see, okay, this is where I've, had white selected. This is where I've masked over. And you can get much more refined. Typically I would use like a tablet, like a drawing tablet to do this. But I'm using the mouse, and you by no means have to have a tablet. In fact, the one that I use for production, I did on my laptop on the trackpad because I forgot my stylus at home. But it turned out great. So by no means does this mean you have to hurry up and go buy a tablet. Try it with a mouse or a trackpad first. I'm left-handed, so it just works out better. Okay, let's go ahead and preview it. All right, so there we go. You have everything masked out. Now, you know, you might be wondering, like, why would you do that? You know, there's nothing in motion or anything. Well, even if you just mask it out, those pixels aren't moving. There's some noise and grain, but all those pixels don't move, and that brings the file size down lower. You can put that on like a GIF or a GIF or on a web page. It's all going to be smaller in file size. There's one big reason to use this instead of just looping video. Of course, there's the artistic side, and we'll see another example of that. So yeah, we masked out everything that we really needed to, but let's say we didn't mask it out good. Like, let's say I just, I missed this here. Yeah, you'll see what it looks like. It looks a little bit weird. You see how, if you look in this area, let me enlarge it, you're going to see like part of the image on top. Oh, it disappeared. Oh, and it came out here. So, you know, loop back, play back, make sure that you have everything that you, everything masked out. Excellent. All right, so we don't want it to be choppy. We don't want to have her, you know, just going right here. Woo, we did a cinemagraph. Too choppy. So I'm gonna find a good spot to, first make a seamless loop and then go back. So it autoplays, so there is a trick that you can use, not there, select the video, a trick that you can use to make it seamless. First, we cut it in half. Let's enlarge this, go over to the small mountains. Now, we're going to deselect both. We're going to make this part, the front, the end. And, you know, it's kind of a weird concept to get used to it at the beginning, but that is actually going to make a seamless loop, because at the end here now comes back to this exact point, and that makes a seamless loop when playing back, and you can fix up the true end over here. So let me just show you what that looks like. See, she goes there, boom, you know, nothing happened, and then when we get to the true end, ugly. Not Chloe. All right. We're going to use a basic fade, and I'm just going to set it to, you know, less than half a second for a transition. And this is going to smooth out our. Let's try a crossfade. That's what you're going to want to use, a crossfade. This is going to smooth out our video. Now, as you take a look. Ah, much better. Of course, I would use something like a ping pong effect, but we're not going to get into that here, and that's probably better suited for After Effects, to be honest. We're going to keep it simple. I'm assuming some of you, or most of you, are graphic designers, so you use Photoshop a lot. And there you go. There's your basic Cinemagraph. Of course, you can put a little bit of text or what have you. You know, we talked about that before. So, how do you render this out? Well, you're going to go to the File tab, and you're going to go to Export, and then Render Video, or Render a GIF. And we'll go over that in a second. Here you go. You can select your format, YouTube 720p, 25 frames per second. That works for me. It doesn't have to be at the frame rate that you had, like 60 frames or 30 frames. That's going to increase the file size. So you can bring it down. It's only a short clip and, you know, it's looping. No big deal. So I would choose this option. You know, select the folder to put it in, of course. And all frames, of course. Then go ahead and hit render. All right. So that's how you do video, but how do you make a GIF? Well, go to File, Export, not Export As. You're going to want to Save for Web, Legacy. And here we go. And this is how you make a GIF. Now there's a bunch of different options that you can choose from. Selective, Diffusion, Transparency, and you get everything here. And save it out. Now, it's going to take a while for me, as you can see the progress bar here is taking a while, and every time you change something, it will take a while. So just keep that in mind when you're making changes. But definitely check it out, and let's just fast forward to when it's done. Okay, so we have it done here. I would zoom out. There we go. As you can see, it didn't come out perfect, and that happens with a lot of them. You can try different styles. We can play it back, you know, especially you can see where we mask everything out or masked or, you know, made a hole for the video. See those pixels dancing around? That's the same type of thing I talked about. This isn't the best picture for, you know, a GIF, but try different modes like adaptive, perceptual. You can go ahead and do that and see the difference. And there you go. You know, that looks a little bit better to me, but, you know, I waited for the whole download. Try this out, go through them, and then you can just hit done, and there's your GIF. So, you know, there's how you do it, but let's see a real-world example. So, this is something I put together for a small business, and as you can see, I just masked out where all the action is happening, where the cream is hitting the coffee. And I just made a freeze frame and, you know, I did the normal Photoshop thing, touch things up, move some curves around, and it just goes back and forth. And it'll just loop continuously. You see that black flicker? You know, that's an issue with the browser, not really how it would look. When you're going through the newsfeed, it'll just loop seamlessly. So do Cinemagraphs work? Well, duh, but it really depends. It depends on what type of platform you put it on and even how you put it. Yeah, you heard that right. How? For instance, on Facebook, if you post a Cinemagraph as a video, it will do much better than if you post it as a GIF. Why? Well, Facebook favors video over GIFs. So, do you have your own tricks or tips when it comes to Cinemagraphs? Let me know in the comments. If you have any questions, again, let me know in the comments. I'd love to answer them for you. That's it for today, but remember to always be learning, and I'll see you next time.